So, hello guys, how are you all? Hope you are good. So, today we are back with our new editorial, and today's editorial is from Goodbye 2020. It is a Code Forces round which held every year. Okay, guys, so this is a kind of a global round, guys. Okay, so we are discussing problem B of this contest. The name of the problem is Last Minute Enhancement. Okay, guys, so let's move to the problem statement. The problem statement says that there is a boy, okay, and he has a musical composition and which he needs to present tomorrow, and unfortunately there is a problem occur in that composition, musical composition, and let's move on to the second paragraph. There is n notes which are represented by positive integers. Suppose the composition is made up of n notes, and the notes are classified as numbers, integers. Okay, and the diversity of the song is the number of different notes it contains. Okay, so diversity, this basically means that the diversity of the song will be the number of distinct integer the set contain, or the notes contain, or the array contain. Okay, guys, so this means the diversity, the number of distinct integers the array could contain. And there is a girl, she wants to help the boy, and to help the boy she can do one thing. She can go to each number, and she can either increase it by one or leave it. Means you can either increment the number by one. Suppose it is two, then you can make it three, or you can leave it as two only. Okay, and our target is to maximize the diversity. Okay. Maximize the diversity of the nodes, or to maximize the distinct element in the array. So this is our target. So this much is the problem statement, guys. And so basically it means that you are given an array and you need to increase the distinct element in that array, and you can do only one operation. You can either increment the ith element by one, or you can do nothing. So let me tell you the logic for this problem. It is straightforward, guys. So suppose this is our array 1 2 2 2 5 6. Okay, there are 1 2 5 6. So our logic will be, we will check that if the ith element has come more than once, okay, if the ith element has come more than once, then we will increment it, else we will do nothing. Okay, so let me tell you what it is mean. Suppose this is our number 1, so it is coming first time only in this array. Okay, so we will do nothing to it. Then go to 2, then we will check. Till here it is coming only once. Okay, till the second position it is coming only once. Now we will move forward, we will do nothing to the first 2 because it is coming only once till here. Now we will go to here, okay, and we will check that if it is coming more than once or not. Yes, at this position it is coming more than once, because we have only there is one more 2 before it. So what we will do in this case is we will increment it. Okay, so we will increment it by 1, so we will make it 3. Okay, guys, so we will increment it by 1 now, and if we will increment it, then we will move forward and we will check the fourth position in number, it is again 2. Okay, guys, and according to this array the 2 has come once more, so we will increment this also because it has come once more. So now this will be counted as 3, and there is 2 2 now, okay, in this array. So we'll increment this also because it is coming twice this time, thrice this time. So we'll make it 3. Okay, so we have cut 2 2s and make them 3. Now we will go to the fifth index, which is 5, and we will check. It is coming only first time. This is first time of the 5, so we will do nothing to it. Next 6, so we will do nothing to it as well. So the number of distinct element in this is before it was 1 2 and 4, 1 2 5 and 6, which was 3, which was 4 basically, and after incrementing this, the number has become 1 2 3 and 3 5 and 6. So now it has become 5. So the answer of this array should be 5. Okay guys, so this is the logic. We will check each element that it has come more than once or not. If it has come more than once, then we will increment it. So let me show you the code for this problem guys now. So this is the code, very simple. We will take an integer n and we will input the array, and we will take k as the previous element. Okay, we will check if the previous element is, and one more thing guys, that the array is sorted. Okay, there is one more thing given in the question, that the array is sorted. Okay, so we will check that from the we will take an integer k, and we will check the k will be the 0th element. Okay, and we will check that run the loop from 1 till less than n. Okay, now we will check that if the ith element, means the vi element, is less than or equals to k. That means if the vi element is less than or equals to k, that means suppose the vi element is equals to 2, okay, and the k will be 3, k will be 2 this in this, because the k is initially the i minus 1 at place. Okay, so this is the k. So the ith element is basically equals to k if we don't increment this now. So what we will do in this case is we will increment the ith place. Okay, so we will make it 3, and then we will make k as the vi. Okay, we will update the k, and after all the updation, what we will do is we will take a set to count the number of distinct element in that array. Okay, and we will insert set, and we will finally print the size of the set, and this will print the number of distinct element in that array. So this much is the logic and the code for this problem guys. I will also put the code link in the description, and don't forget to check that out, and I will also post the solution for C as well and A as well. So thanks for watching guys. Meet you guys next time. Till then, bye bye.